Factoring tricks, difference of squares. So in this video, we're going to look at what happens when we multiply together a plus b times a minus b, just like right here. So we'll use our FOIL, we'll end up with a squared, and the outside terms together will give us minus ab. Inside terms would be plus ab. And then our last terms, plus b minus b, would give us minus b squared. And we can see that these two middle terms drop out right here. So we've seen this shortcut before, that when we've got something plus something else and then something minus that same something else, that we can shortcut it down to the first thing squared minus the second thing squared. So we're now going to use this trick backwards so that when we're factoring, we can go from this back to the factored form, two expressions multiplied together. So when we're looking at the difference of squares, which is what we call this, a square number minus a square number, we can break it down into the sum of the square roots. And the square roots is just the square root of a squared is a, and the square root of b squared is b. And we can multiply that times the difference of the square roots. So you can see how that works out over here, that we've got the sum of a square root, b a square root, times the difference, a minus b. So let's actually go ahead and look at a couple of examples with more numbers in them, so we can see how it might play out in those situations. So example one, we've got a squared minus 81. So this term right here is going to be our a squared, and this term right here is going to be our b squared. So our a squared is a squared, and our b squared is 81. So then when we take the square root, the square root of a squared will just be a. The square root of b squared, or our b, will be 9. So now we can go ahead and plug this into our factored expression. I'm going to go ahead and use this formula right here. So we'll have the sum of the square roots, a plus 9, and the difference of the square roots, a minus 9, using our square roots, which are a and 9. So let's go ahead now and look at what happens when we FOIL this together. We'll get first terms a squared, outside terms minus 9a, inside terms plus 9a, and then the last terms minus 81. So the magic with this trick is that the middle terms cross out, cancel each other out, and we'll just be left with a squared minus 81, our original expression. So this is successfully factored. Okay, so now let's go ahead and look at something a little bit more complicated. 49x squared minus 25y squared. So here, this whole first term is going to be our a squared, and this whole second term is going to be our b squared. So our a squared is 49x squared, and our b squared is 25y squared. So I'm going to take the square root of each of those, and a will leave us with 7x, and b, we'll take the square root of this number, and we get 5, and the square root of that y squared will give us just a y. So now, these are our square roots, and we can plug them back into our expression. So we will have 7x plus, for the sum, 5y times 7x minus, for the difference, 5y. And again, we can double check this, multiply it together, we get 49x squared minus 35xy plus 35xy and minus 25y squared. And our middle terms will cancel out, and we're left with 49x squared minus 25y squared, exactly the same as our original. So right here, where we have the two expressions multiplied together, this is successfully factored using our shortcut of difference of squares.